Amy. This is Charlie. Come see me, bud. Come on. Come see me. Good boy. This video, I want to show you a little trick that I did with Charlie when I first started him, and I wanted to start him bareback. But his back isn't the most comfortable, and I was intending to grip and pull on his face, and I didn't want to do all that. So what I came up with is get a long, soft rope and tie it around him like how the bronc riders do. Tie a rope up here. You want it, you know, pretty snug. It's kind of loose, but you want it pretty snug. And let's see, show you. And I found this really helpful. Can you come see me? Come on. Good boy. Come on. There you go. A little bit more. Very nice. No. There you go. Just brought him out. I'm unsure. You can be a little nervous. Tell him you're coming on. Like that. And you want that rope right by your crotch. And you want to sit deep. See, I was going to do the neck rope, and I was going to hold on to his mane, but he doesn't have that much mane. But I found that if you use a neck rope or you use the rein to hold on to help you with your balance, you tend to lean a little more forward. So I found that this rope helps you sit deep and sit a little back, which you want to sit just a tad back when you do bareback. And all I did, get this right. It should be a little snugger, but this will work. Is I put my hand underneath, and then I would get, you want a loop rein, and I get the loop rein to sit in your hand, so you're holding both of them, and you want to kind of pull up, so you're pushing yourself down, and you want to sit back just a tad, sit yourself deep, let your legs dangle, but kind of touch the horse, you know, just let them hang where they want to hang. And what I found was, instead of, riding bareback and holding the reins and getting unbalanced, you tend to pull on their face, or you tend to grip at their legs a little bit more and scares them, especially if they're not used to riding bareback. So what I found is I got this rope, put my loop reins in there, and I would pull myself down, and that way I have this hand free to, if I want to turn him or stop him, or if he's getting a little silly, I can shut him down pretty fast. So I'll demonstrate. Walk off, pull yourself down. You got this hand to help you guide him. Just like that. Boom. Just like that. Good boy. Yeah, see, he's an anxious horse, so. See, I found that, you know, he's really uncomfortable. If you have a uncomfortable horse, this is a really, really good way to do it. Because he doesn't have, like my other horse, he doesn't have that fat back where you just, you know, feel like you're sitting in a recliner. He has a little narrow, his spine, kind of feel his spine a little bit. So this is what I did. So what you want to do, get a rope, have it snug, put it kind of like by your crotch, you put your hand underneath, get your loop rein, you want to kind of long, you don't want to be touching and pulling on them if you lose your balance a little bit. So you have this hand, like this, where if you need to turn them, or stop them, or if you need to stop, you can. So just make sure, you know, you sit deep, you hold on to the rope and the loop rein, and you pull yourself down, sit a little bit back, and then you have this hand free to do, you know, whatever you need to do. And this helped me a lot with Charlie. He was a very nervous horse. I don't know why I wanted to start bareback, but that's what I wanted to do with him. And this is this is the little trick that helped me and him. So I could concentrate on staying balanced up here without pulling on his face and squeezing him with my legs, and he doesn't have to worry about me doing all that. And I just, you know, just move with him, find your balance, and you know, it works great. So hopefully this helps. It helped me, so thank you.